First of all, I think what Embibe is doing is that it's redefining education technology and focusing on what technology can do better than the educators, right? So I was recently in Vietnam and giving a talk on the topic of the learning outcomes artificial intelligence stack, which is a completely new way to look at edtech. We're like, let's do away with peripheral solutions, which are, you know, here is more digitized content, you know, for your classroom, and let's focus on what the students want, what the teachers want, which is higher quality education, a pedagogy which is driven entirely through artificial intelligence that can supplement the supply of low quality teachers, okay, and can actually create teachers where there are no teachers available in India. So that's what we are doing. It's not content, this is personalization powered by artificial intelligence on a platform that can work for any educational context in the world. One of the things that keeps me up at night is the quality of technology talent that is continuously being engaged in solving this problem. We have probably the best team in India, you know, in terms of both data science and technology, but there are so many problems that we've defined that we want to solve that the next big step for us is to engage the world's intelligence in solving those problems. And so we stay up at night looking at, you know, the open AI portfolio in the Valley, you know, which is run by Elon Musk. Or we look at, you know, research and publications being, you know, coming up in universities in the US and Israel and other places, and like, how do we get some of this intelligence in? How do we get these researchers excited about what we're building? And that's some of the things that we're doing now. Focus on outcomes. That's it. Focus on results. I think it's very easy to peddle content through call centers, and with, you know, I mean, it's not a right or a wrong thing. It's about what you want to focus your money on as an entrepreneur, right? I don't think anybody really goes wrong because there's a market which is available for content digitization as well. And I think from a consumer standpoint, it is about the perception of what can exist. So for example, before Facebook came, you never knew Facebook was possible, right? So if somebody talked to you about Facebook, you wouldn't really understand it. So if consumers understand that it's actually possible for every child to improve, no matter what their background, you know, that is a market that is worth creating, in my view. Because after a point, you know, content on a tablet is content on a tablet. So the last 4 years has been about building the tech properly and deeply enough. You know, our first market was the IIT and medical entrance exam. The reason we picked that up is it's the toughest market, both in terms of time spent as well as in terms of, you know, improving students, because they're very tough exams, right? And also in terms of the quality and the type of content that you process at the back end, complex symbols and whatnot. 4.5 years later, we've cracked the code on learning outcomes, you know, which focuses on both deep knowledge interventions as well as improving behaviors of students, making them better test takers. This framework is now ready to scale. Okay, so the next 2 to 3 years is going to be about taking this framework to every education market in the country, right from post-college exams to K-12, and actually focusing on, you know, leveraging this technology to help a student improve all the way through. I'd like to add one more thing in terms of the disruption that's being created by Embibe. So, you know, there are a lot of things you can do with technology. For example, in a hospital, you know, you could build a photocopier or you could build the MRI machine. The difference between the two is you could do without a photocopier, you can't do without the MRI machine, because that's mainstream to diagnosis. Today, technology is not mainstream to education, it's an add-on. The only way it becomes mainstream is if it is harnessed to do something which the naked eye cannot do, right? And the harnessing of, you know, that technology yields disproportionate results for everybody involved, because MRIs save lives, right? So one of the things that we've built is based on the fact that all of knowledge is connected, you know, right from grade one to the last exam you'll ever take. It sits one on top of another, right? But there is no way that humankind today can access that flow of knowledge or concepts, which is why when you go to higher grades, your teachers tell you, you know, I wish you had come to me sooner, because there's no way they can go and deep dive into your past and fix what's wrong. So Embibe is building the learning continuum that connects every grade. And I'll give you some fun facts, okay? 1,000 concepts in chemistry in 12th grade come directly from the 8th grade, you know? So if you've not fixed the 8th grade, you're not going to do well in the 12th grade. But if you've not done it right, do you have an option to go back and fix exactly what is needed? You don't, right? So that is something that Embibe has built, which is super unique. You know, a taxonomy of about 40,000 concepts, which connect subjects to each other and grades to each other, and put the power of improvement in the hands of the consumer. You know, so these are just some of the innovations that are being built, but harnessing technology for what technology can do better and not just sort of becoming yet another content dissemination platform. So the last 10 years has been about optimization. So for example, we're talking about, you know, better feedback systems in cars. We've been talking about, you know, let's say content on tablets or whatnot. The next 10 years and 5 years is going to be about changing the paradigms on which these optimizations are happening, because the industries themselves will fundamentally shift. We'll go in healthcare from better, you know, medicine, you know, delivery to gene level manipulation. You know, in education, we'll go from, you know, delivering content and books to no books, right? In cars, we'll probably go from optimizing roads to optimizing for an entirely different mode of transport altogether. Because technology cycles are now maturing, early experiments are scaling through commercial viability.